present the State of the University Address. It's my honor to present to you President Sidney A. McPhee.
Thank you, Dr. Bartel, and good morning. And I have approached the beginning over the years of this new academic year with tremendous anticipation. And that sense is heightened as I reflect upon the prospects ahead for this year, for the centennial of our founding is just a few days away, and with it, the beginning of a year-long celebration of our remarkable university's history and its future. So this year, I say these are exciting and historic times for our university, not only because it is our 100th birthday, but also because we're entering our second century with strong momentum, great promise, and enormous potential. For the past 2 years, at this gathering, I've spoken of the hard work and efforts in implementing the series of recommendations outlined in our Positioning the University for the Future initiative. These efforts identified ways to reduce costs and improve efficiencies while protecting, and I might add, while protecting, in some cases, and enhancing selected academic programs central to our mission. Because we tackle the challenges head on and focus the university on moving forward, we entered, ladies and gentlemen, this fiscal year fully prepared to address the significant budget reductions without major disruption to the university day-to-day operation. I want you to know, and I stand before you today telling you that we are able to address these major financial reductions by taking a proactive stance through good financial management of your university. And with the addition of one-time financial allocation due to the phase-in of our new outcome-based formula funding by the Tennessee Higher Education Commission. As a result, for this new fiscal year, no division of the university will be asked to make any additional cuts beyond those already made. So far, we are done with the cuts. Hold your hands, keep your fingers crossed. I hope you saw the news in the local media this past May when our athletics program learned it had won the Sun Belt Conference All-Sports Trophy. This award represents the best all-around athletic program in the conference. MTSU has won this honor 7 times since joining the league in 2001, and it has secured this title for the last 3 years in a row. We became just the third school in Sun Belt history to win the award 7 times, and no school has won the award more since the Blue Raiders joined the league in 2001. During the spring 2011 semester, 138 of our 301 student athletes, or 46%, had a grade point average of 3.0 or higher, while 69 made the dean's list and 23 had a perfect 4.0 GPA. Ladies and gentlemen, we are a national model for success, winning championship, and our student athletes doing well in the classroom. The NCAA comes to MTSU for guidance and direction. Now on a matter of private fundraising. Last year, I'm proud to report that this year was a banner year in private fundraising for our university. Compared to the previous year, giving was up by more than 30%. Simply put, this is a remarkable achievement. These times demand different thinking, and certainly different revenue streams in order for us to continue the level of service we wish to provide. With regards to our efforts to improve our facilities, I'm proud to report that the new College of Education, where's Dean Lanasiva, she's right here, is now open and ready for business for this fall. Plans are underway to renovate the Learning Resource Center to house the interior design and textile merchandise and design program and provide needed infrastructure updates for that department. Construction will begin in December and extend through next summer. Women's basketball office on the lower level of Murphy Center will be ready by the start of this semester. The project is supported by a $600,000 gift from alumnus Ken Coachship. Our new dairy facility at MTSU Farm is completed. We are the only school in the state, in Tennessee, where students can get hands-on I'm a guy from the beach. I'm from the Bahamas, but they told me in the country to do it hands-on. Practical experience in milk production while learning about food safety, cattle management, and quality assurance. The new student union is on schedule and will be ready for occupancy next summer. Renovation of Deer and Nix Hall is complete and marks the completion of a 10-year, and as I told Sarah Dirks, and Dr. Sells, it is the Taj Mahal. They have done a wonderful job in the renovation of this, all of our residence hall, and that completes the whole project, which was a 10-year master plan. And ladies and gentlemen, as you know, as you walk to this facility today, construction continues on roadway improvements that will widen and enhance MTSU Boulevard and the roundabout to Jones Hall and other parts of the university. We ask for your patience. This will allow for more efficient bus service shuttle to our campus with our student. It will improve pedestrian walkways, and it will be finished sometime this spring. And this fall, you will see, we engage in a project this summer improving lighting across the campus, and that will be completed. Today, I also wish to draw your attention to the work of our task force on nonviolence and conflict resolution. This group, headed by Vice President Deb Sells, was charged with developing a comprehensive and ongoing plan to teach, train, and research ways to reinforce positive conflict resolution. It is my desire and goal to promote a campus environment that embraces civility and celebrates diversity. A web page is being created and will include recommendations and strategies outlined by the task force. This initiative resulted from the unfortunate incidents occurring last spring, and I encourage you and ask that you support this initiative, and I want the committee under Dr. Sales' leadership to know how much I appreciate their good work. We have a series and a very outstanding video that will be launched very shortly for this community, and I think you'll be proud of that. Now, you may also have heard that the university has enacted a tobacco-free campus policy. And in essence, this means that the use of all forms of tobacco product will be prohibited on university property. We feel that this policy is not about denying rights. It's about promoting and creating a healthy environment for all. We're not focusing on tobacco users as much as we are focusing on the behavior in public spaces we all share. As I've said before, I'm extremely proud of our faculty, staff, students, and alumni. We make up more than just an academic community, we are family. And together we strive to live up to our tradition of excellence as Tennessee's best comprehensive university. For the past 100 years, we have provided our students with unique and meaningful opportunities to unlock their intellectual potential so they may realize the promise in their future. Ladies and gentlemen, we remain firmly committed to being the number one choice for undergraduates in the state of Tennessee. We are the number one producer of college graduates in the greater Nashville region, and we're the second largest producer of graduates in our entire state among public universities. As budgetary concerns magnify the need for wise spending of the public monies, I'm proud to report that we are also the most efficient producer of graduates among state universities, helping more students reach their educational goals for less tax dollars per pupil from the state of Tennessee. We have maintained our academic quality and have been good stewards of the resources by keeping sight on three important goals set forth in our 10-year academic master plan: enhancing academic quality, promoting a student-centered living and learning environment, and leveraging partnership with business and industry. As we near the midpoint of this master plan, and as we adapt to our new expectations as outlined in the Complete College Tennessee Act, I will be developing further ways to measure and report how the work of each college, each department, and administrative unit is contributing to our plan. It is vital that all of us not only embrace this plan, but we must also be able to identify tangible results. I look forward to celebrating our centennial starting today and throughout the entire academic year. We have a terrific team of alumni, fans, friends, students, faculty, and staff that have been working for months to provide us a wonderful array of events, features, and specials that will fill us with even more pride for MTSU. In conclusion, I want you to know that I remain proud and humble to have the privilege for the past 10 plus years of leading this great university. I appreciate your attendance and the patience today. I look forward to working with each of you in this coming centennial academic year. And ladies and gentlemen, I cannot wait for this academic year to begin on Monday, because we have so much to cheer about. And in spite of all of the gloom and doom of the economy, this university is on the move, and it's on the move because of people like you in this room. Thank you for being a part of this great academic institution. Thank you very much.